Over the span of a single calendar year, the Me Too movement has been transformed into the most potent political vehicle of the liberal left towards disempowering white, heteronormative men sexually, socially, and politically. And it continues to maintain its poisonous grip on the cultural narrative along the gateways of social media. Despite many of its earliest targets being men of Jewish background, it has quickly become the latest psyop to be weaponized against the imaginary white male patriarchy, which one can safely assume was the main goal all along. What began in October 2017 as a manufactured social media uproar has evolved into a shrill chorus of collective vitriol, aimed almost exclusively at white masculinity. This has had the intended secondary effect of raising political animus towards President Trump and the Republicans. But more critically, it has ignited an artificial debate on whether the white heterosexual male should have a stake in the future of Western civilization at all, indeed in any human sphere, whether political, social, or even sexual. With the full backing of Hollywood's white, middle-class women of privilege and cable media joints such as The View, this latest phase of the war against white masculinity has had a corrosive effect, tainting nearly every public digital space. As such, it has become a sort of digital policeman, directing the traffic of human interactions accordingly, a self-regulating piece of social programming that has achieved quasi-permanence. But, in essence, it could only have functioned if the general public had been suitably softened to accept the prime diktat of the globo-homo-liberal elite, which is that there exists a white male privilege which somehow victimizes and oppresses all other classes, races, and sexes. That the Me Too gambit has been so successful underscores a victory for the social engineers. Decades of indoctrinating a large chunk of the Western populace to believe in white male privilege seem to have paid off. This brings the discussion to one Brett Kavanaugh, who has recently become just the latest instrument of propaganda for the mainstream media circus. It is no exaggeration to state that what will come to decide the lawmaking landscape of the United States for the next 30 years now depends on a bogus character smear campaign marshalled by the leftist legacy media establishment and their covert handlers within the deep state. These operations are transparent to anyone with an ounce of impartiality, and their outcome will be felt throughout Western society. Mr. Kavanaugh is a conservative judge who sat on the Court of Appeal for the Washington, D.C. Circuit. Those who occupy this bench have more power than the president himself. Kavanaugh was chosen by Donald Trump to replace Justice Anthony Kennedy on the Supreme Court, where members can remain for decades, controlling the social evolution of America's laws until they die. One such Supreme Court justice, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, has made it her roost for 25 years, after Bill Clinton appointed her in 1993. She is now 85 years old, is a staunch neo-Marxist liberal with strong ties to Israel, and her political radicalism in that time has greatly shaped the social order of America. Mr. Kavanaugh's future as a Supreme Court justice, something that the entire anti-Western liberal establishment is fighting against, now rests upon the allegations brought by three women who claim they were sexually assaulted by him some 35 years ago, while he was still attending high school and college. The testimonies are fraught with inconsistencies, but these are simply subsumed in the war of image versus reality. How the target appears to the general public, the photoshopped meme of the white conservative male from the old European order, and how he can be vilified or portrayed is all that matters to the media gatekeepers. And for now, it seems, their psyop is working where it needs to, in the public's imagination. The pattern of anti-white, anti-male, anti-Christian rhetoric is made more conspicuous whenever a turning point is reached in this decades-long culture war against the West. These events, despite their being sordid and mundane, require diligent examination, for they exhibit the base, vapid character of the enemy, while demonstrating its tactical and legal ploys. Mr. Kavanaugh's situation is a particularly intriguing one, in that a myriad of left-wing liberal initiatives over the course of two decades now depend on this gambit. It is a faux game of chess, played by a group who fears to confront their opponent directly, hoping only to win by attrition. With all its resources, political clout, and military backup ever present if required, the Globo Homo liberal elite has all the time in the world. Their objective from the outset was to overthrow the West through social and political attrition, and one need not have to read Saul Alinsky to grasp this. However, all is not lost. There is a silver lining to this masquerade. With each new ruse tricked out by the liberal establishment, there grows an increasingly hostile audience. For nature imbues itself into everything, and humanity is not immune. With every action they commit, there will be a reaction they cannot foresee, despite their engineering prowess. This piece of chaos, this infinite thing of spirit, is already gathering its forces while collecting a consciousness within the vanguard of the European nationalist movement. One slight miscalculation, a simple overplay of a hand, and the veil will slip so completely that there will be nothing the enemy of Western man can do to prevent nature from taking its course.